we'll see how this matchup ends up developing.
Gotcha. And yeah, to be fair, Quib used his Pokemon trainer during the Ditto versus Noku, so it wasn't all Steve. But anyway, we're on to game one, and Quib is right out the gate using the Squirtle to his best advantage, as we all know him for famously.
Yeah, and that's just a weird character to combo, though.
Yeah.
He has a lot of quick moves, and at the same time, his air dodge is just so wonky.
Yeah.
But one thing about Squirtle in this matchup is that if he does manage to get Ness off stage, Water Gun can be really scary.
That's correct, because basically I call it like the horizontal version of Mario's Flood, if you think about it. Like, exactly, yeah. See that? Because Mario would send you up, but it just sends you to send it straight away. And now the Ivysaur has come out with a whip! Perfect kill from Quid. 75%, and Tony's on his second stock.
Yeah, oh man. So that's like, oh man.
Oh no. Oh. Excellent comeback from Tony. But now the Charizard's out extremely early, really? I guess trying to get him off stage at least. But
he's at death percent. I can see why he goes hard.
Oh, he's trying to get him off stage and oh no.
Yeah, at that point, could he have gone down and body blocked it, or is Tony still close that even then he would have made it back?
So far it seems like it, but thankfully he switches out just in time before the combo train comes in to even out the stock, but...
Yeah.
Or with the PK Flash? Interesting.
I mean, PK Flash from Ness is... We've seen especially people like PK Chris use it fantastically, even in juggle situations. So this is still a position that, Quid is favored here. Ivysaur of 87%.
Oh, that's a tricky recovery. That Vine Whip is crazy, man.
Yeah, but at the same time, if you've ever seen it, if just the tail of the PK Thunder hits, it ruins Ivysaur's day. Because he doesn't really take knockback, but his Vine still goes away. Mm-hmm. So we might see it here this time around. He's being so careful. You see he's playing around it beautifully.
Yep, and there goes the Ivysaur. So the Charizard returns and will just be the kill, and he just runs into that. You gotta use he's taking advantage of the Fire Breath. Trying to save it.
No invincibility, yeah.
But Howard, that's a dead Ness.
I like the idea from Tony Pajamas right there. Putting up that PK Fire can mean re-grabbing the ledge is a lot generally easier to do. But Quid just played around it beautifully, and that F-Tilt has so much range. So I think we're probably going to see less planking from Tony Pajamas and the rest of this set, considering the fact that it's just immediately shown.
Not to mention, also Charizard's down tilt can also be pretty effective off stage too.
Yes. I will say right there that if that water gun had connected, that would have been so bad for Tony because he had no time.
Oh,
he would have wound up off stage.
He didn't go for the tech. You know, for the tech scenario.
Okay.
He's just waiting him out. He's just trying to catch him up in the air.
Yeah, oh man, he is looking for it. But these moves from, that was such a questionable down air, but in the end, I think it was just a bait. He didn't get anything off of it, but right now, both of these players, they're deep in the red, looking for that final hit. Tony managing to push him off stage, neutral air. I don't think he has a jump. He's forced to go Zard,
and the
down smash is enough. What a beautiful edge guard from Tony Pajamas.
I was thinking that he could have flare blitz, but yet again, he had to be at risk if he did the wrong move. But however, if Tony did flare blitz right, if Tony did not do a different option, that was actually in Quid's favor.
Yeah. I mean, it kind of came down to a bit of a 50-50, but it's like a 50-50 where if he guesses wrong, he loses.
Yeah. So. And Quid, he's still looking a little puzzled, but I think he can solve it easily.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, Quid is one of those players where his game ones versus his games twos and threes, like, he can really pick somebody apart and just absolutely dumpster
that. That sounds scary.
Yeah, no, that's it's not.
And I had the feeling of that when I was fighting Zapdos earlier.
Yeah. Oh man. Moving into game two now, though, I will say if Tony Pajamas manages to get this upset here, because it would be an upset if he takes out Quid, that'd be really big for him. But
oh yeah, that's right. It's also best out of five.
Yep, that is in fact the case.
I just realized because I'm like, before, because the previous set, I'm like, is this best out of three? And I'm like, then it's over. But now it's still continuing. And Quid is still fighting back as he rightfully should with the Squirtle.
This is kind of similar to that way that first game went, though, where the Squirtle combos are.
Reads a roll with the Aqua Jet, I believe, correct?
That's Waterfall.
My bad. Sorry.
It's fine. All of the moves are like the Pokemon. I think every single one of his moves is named after
something. You're 100% correct on that. Like Ivysaur, like, you know, Bullet Seed, Razor Leaf, Vine Whip, and with Charizard, Flare Blitz, Fire Umbral, Flamethrower, and Fly. Gotcha. See, I saw.
R.I.P. Rock Smash.
See, I know my terminology here. But he's.
Oh, this should be death. He's not going to go down there?
Oh, and. He's still texting. Oh no!
He just barely missed the ledge. That was honestly a beautiful recovery from Tony Pajamas. But just at the end, they're slightly off.
Yep, and now he's just taking advantage of Ness being in the air, thankfully. Uses the up tilt. Interesting move, like as Yoshi has the same thing, like to try to use Yoshi's egg roll. But oh no, another SD. It hurts to see this.
You doing okay, bud?
Regardless of the character hate and love, but that hurt, man.
Listen, even you never want to see people drop stocks like that.
If
you I don't know if you
have
to jump.
Excellent recovery and defense options with the neutral air. Fails to grab.
Oh, okay. Again with the up tilt. I guess he's trying to cover like a jump in that situation, but
yeah, that's what he's basically going to be doing because
the arm.
Because, like, the leaves, I mean, you know, the extra Vime supporting Ivysaur when he goes up, that does not have a hitbox. Mm. It's only Ivysaur, Ivysaur elevating
it can
his
be
body.
Like, it's almost like pseudo, like, and Sora down smash, where he kind of displaces himself.
I guess. And that was an interesting Rapid Spin to get out of there. Or was it Razor Shell?
I think that one's Rapid Spin.
And
oh, good job reading that tech. It covers so many options to just hit the down smash right there.
Yeah, that's another thing I'm also on the scene that Quid is finally doing is taking advantage of tech scenarios because he was not doing that at all until now.
Yeah, and
takes advantage of the air dodge.
Yeah, he knows that.
And excellent up tilt and the patience to knock him down or set him up.
That was really good awareness also, knowing in that situation that up air was kind of the only move Ivysaur had that would kill. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of the times players, especially lower level players, if they see somebody, like they're off stage, if they're off stage, they will hit them and they'll just like go for the move that will just hit them off stage again, even if that's not necessarily the finisher, you know? Like it's important to keep track of your opponent's percent, and if you have the opportunity to go for an up air that will kill, that's the move to go for in that situation.
Correct, and not to mention another thing I've also been seeing is that Tony's recoveries have kind of been poor this match because they either not connecting, either missing, or Quid realizing when the end lag is over.
Yeah, Quid has just been like really figuring out the options that sort of like Ness is one of those characters where it feels like he has panic options off stage, you know, where he's like, I don't feel comfortable going for my PK Thunder, so now I'm going to air dodge to the ledge here. And he's just been punishing that beautifully, especially with that Ivysaur neutral air. And
he's a definition of panic options off stage too. PK Fire, PK Fire, running,
oh yeah, it's just panic
tilts.
Every which way. If somebody is off stage in the Ness matchup, there is just so much adrenaline flying.
Yeah. Especially as a Luigi, because also I play Luigi here and I have to make some my recoveries hard. When I was playing with a Rosa player, like for example, like she would just send down the Lumas after me. I would just have to get around that because if one touch, I'm dead. But anyway, off topic, but
yeah, well, it's not just gonna take one touch to kill Ness, but we're seeing death by a thousand cuts is Quid. Tony Pajamas finally managing to get a little bit of stage control here, but it's gone just in an instant. He's really struggling to find some way to, you know, take a hit and run with it.
And not to mention,
that's death.
Yep. And also, fun fact: Ivysaur's down throw is actually the second strongest in the game.
His back throw, you mean?
No, it was down throw.
Oh, his down throw.
It's the second strongest in the game.
Who's the first strongest?
That's kind of a reason why I got whipped by Noku, but
yeah, I mean he's the only character. He's one of who's the other character with a down throw kill throw? Not Corrin.
I guess Joker. But
that's
not
stronger than Ivysaur, is it?
No. But But anyway, Quinn is finally taking advantage of him off stage, and that's a dead nest.
That was so good. And you saw Tony went for that PK flash. He's like, I want to keep you off of me. And Quinn just stayed there on the stage, recognized it was coming. And then at that point, he was so much lower, his options were limited that much more. The down air from Ivysaur was enough.
And he used all of his three Pokemon perfectly in the situation with the off-picking Charizard, neutral, the mixed options from Squirtle, and the defense just to get the kill with Ivy. And now it's a back out again. Is this going to happen again? And it does happen again. Come on, Quinn.
That was
You're
like the
beacon for me here. Come on.
That was like the tippy tip of the down air. That was like the freaking tangent lines of that giant ass orb that he just drops.
Yeah, that flower is something else, man. It's not good for smelling, but it's good for killing here. What is in that flower?
Explosives. C4. It's snake C4.
Except it kills downwards.
It's just a kill. Except the up one kills upwards.
Yeah. Remember, they actually nerfed that the summer of 2019, actually. And they gave Charizard a bit more offense.
Nerf. They nerfed the
sweet
spot.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Well, they nerfed the sweet spot, which, as far as I understand, I don't think anybody's ever gotten hit by the sweet spot of that down air.
And oh my god, come on!
I had mentioned it at the very beginning of this game, and that's why Tony has been so eager to air dodge to the ledge.
Also,
because if he's not careful, especially against Squirtle, he just dies!
Yeah, speaking of which, also shout out to a European Pokemon trainer, Garu. I know him that he loves taking advantage of the Wargo. The gun I'm fighting against Wario is a Wario bike. Because that hits like an actual truck. But now Squirtle is hitting like a truck. And now the Ivysaur is coming out.
Oh no.
This is the Razor Stall, and that's a perfect kill, and he makes it back.
He's at
perfect angles and perfect recovery here.
He's at 23%.
I think this is maybe over for Tony.
He's
got to pick something up now. Unless he's Sonics to just, just to three stock, obviously three stock Cloudy at SWT with full rage on his last stock, but something has to happen here, and this is ugly. This is pretty ugly.
God. You know, I was saying before how it's like Quid Game 2 and 3 is a totally different beast. So Quid Game 4 is an absolute monster. Sheesh.
Yeah, because we're playing Quid's game here. Am I right?
Finally, Magic Sing. And actually, that was a pretty uncontested stock, if you think about it. That was almost a zero to death, or close to it. So, Tony doing a good job of not being shook too much, but he still has so much difficulty.
But, however, Tony is now fighting back and realizing a few things, but. Or not, because he's back off stage.
The thing is, yes, he was doing a good
job.
That's
an interesting way to recover with the PK Flash.
Well, the thing is that it keeps the opponent off a lot. You know, it at the very least, gets them to or motivates them.
And he's dead.
I can't remember the last time I've seen an Ivysaur up smash.
And I don't think we can even compensate properly because of how quick these games are. Quid! Amazing 3-1 victory.
Yeah, a reverse
over Tony Pajamas, and this is not an upset.